Good morning, everyone. A good tavach, Shavua Tov. We are continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, blessings for specific situations. And he writes, "Hamispale al masha ova," a person who prays on something that took place in the past. Kagoyin sheshama koil tzavcha, but here he hears a voice, a sound of screaming in the city. Va'oymen, he says, "Hiratza in shuloye koil ze besoich besi." May it be your will, Hashem, that this cry is not taking place within my house. Or someone's wife is pregnant. And after 40 days from the pregnancy, he prays and he says, may it be your will, Hashem, that my wife give birth to a boy. Both of these prayers are what's called reciting a prayer in vain. Why? Because the event already took place and it can't be changed. If there's screaming in the city and God forbid it was in your house, it took place already. If your wife is more than 40 days pregnant, Hashem already decided if it's a boy or a girl. So therefore you're praying in vain. However, if you daven within 40 days of pregnancy, then your prayer could be effective. And you're able to pray regarding your child's gender, what you would like it to be. Because as the Mishnah Berurah writes, for the first 40 days, the child is yet unformed. And therefore, prayer could be effective to determine the gender of that child. However, after 40 days, your prayer should be, may HaKadosh Baruch Hu make this child viable, which means it should be a seed of life that is going to be lasting. Toiv l'shamayim, he should develop good towards heaven. V'toiv l'brios, and he should be good towards his fellow creations, meaning that his actions should find favor in the eyes of those of Hashem and those around him. And therefore, he writes also, he brings down that when it comes to the screaming that takes place in the city, the screaming is already there. Obviously, something wrong is already taking place. What should you daven? For example, if a person heard that there's a fire in the city, he can daven the following. If there's a fire in his house, then his family should be spared from the harm. That would also be an appropriate prayer for a person to say. Next halacha. And he writes like this, Hanichnas Lamaydes Grana. A person enters into his storehouse to measure all the grain that he has. V'kiyotze by a similar activity. We'll translate this into our business. Yispalel v'yoymar. He should pray the following. Yirotze mufanecha Hashem alakai. May it be your will, Hashem. Shetishlach bracha b'kriyazeh. That you bestow blessing into this pile of grain. Hischil Lamayd. A person begins to measure it. Oymer. Baruch HaShelech, Bracha BeKriyazeh, blessed is the one who bestows blessing on this pile of grain. Baruch V'Oimer B'Loi Shem U'Malchus, he says it without the name, without Hashem's holy name. Modad V'Achakach Yispalel, if you already measure the grain and then you pray for the blessing to come, Harezeh Tefillah Shav, the same thing, it's a tefillah, a prayer that's in vain. Because blessing is only found in those things that are hidden from the eye, which means when the quantity of your produce is not yet known, that's where the bracha can come. Now that it's already been assembled and it's already been collected in this pile, therefore it's no longer hidden from the eye, the bracha now is in vain. So similarly, I guess we would say in business that before the deal is made, before the check is written, there a person is mispala, they daven that everything should go well and Hashem should give them success. After the check is done, after the deal is closed, it's going to be what it's going to be. Perhaps you could daven that there should be continued success in the work of my hands. But to daven that things should change within the amount of money that's coming in right now already, that much is called a tefillah shav. It's a prayer that is in vain. Wishing everybody a successful week in Ruchnius and Gashmius, in the spiritual and in their physical livelihood. And Be'ez Hashem, we shall continue learning the halachas tomorrow. A good tevach, Shavua Tov, a good week to everyone.